gonna love me for my ambition.
Shout out to everybody out in the world watching this right now. You could be doing anything at all, but I appreciate you. You're here. I go by Sound. This is the CA channel, the Club Ambition channel, and I'm going to review and react right now. My first time listening to it fully, the Beyonce Break My Soul single off of the Act One Renaissance album. It's been, I think, about, 5 years coming on below the Beehive since we got an official solo studio album from Beyonce, and the people have been waiting, and now it's happening. It feels like the music culture, the whole world is like stopping and like acknowledging it. Let's watch the lyric video together. If you want to watch this fully uncensored, unedited, uncut, go to my Patreon, patreon.com/clubambition. The actual link is going to be in the description and in the comments. So let's get into it right now. Okay, so right away I recognize that. That's Big Frida. If you don't know Big Frida by now, you don't know music. Shout out to Big Frida, the queen of the bounce. Okay. Oh! Oh! Damn! Gotta let the hair loose for this one.
You won't break my soul. I'm telling everybody. Everybody. I just quit my job. Don't find no drive in all past life. And they work my nerves. That's why I cannot sleep at night.
Definitely a house party anthem, and this is definitely a house music summer 2022. First the Drake album, and then we have the Beyonce. Coincidence? I think not. Remember, there was a Beyonce Drake record that leaked, rumored, whatever. There was supposed to be a collab. I think maybe they're working on this type of music together. Obviously Beyonce's not on the Drake album, but maybe Drake's on the Beyonce album. Because it can't be a crazy coincidence, right? Like, that's a wild coincidence. I'm not saying they're copying each other. But the timing is crazy. You know, and the Drake album, in my opinion, was great. But this Beyonce album is probably going to be obviously better.
Release the job. Release the time. Release the dream. Release the stress.
B is back and I'm sleeping real good, and the B, she's back.
Planes in the front and a dom's in the back.
Oh!
Taking no flicks, but the whole click snapped.
Damn!
A whole lot of trying to smoke with the yak in your mouth.
Damn!
And we back outside, but you ain't that outside.
Outside.
In case you forgot how we act outside.
Beyonce's outside!
Yeah.
You won't take my soul. You won't break my soul. Wow!
You
won't break my soul. I'm telling everybody. Yo, Big Frida better be a millionaire. Wow. Wow. Okay. I'll give the Beyonce record like an 8.5 out of 10. I think it's a great record. It gives me the house party vibes, but to her own way, she's rapping on there. She's damn near rapping more than Drake rapped on his house songs. And it's very reminiscent of the Azalea Banks sound. Shout out to Azalea Banks, K-Tronada. House party and house music, rather, has existed in the black culture. Black people created house music. We've created it. We created that, if we really go down historically, but it's become a white thing. Now we have the black artists of popularity reclaiming house music back. Drake and Beyonce, the two biggest, if possible. Biggest female, biggest male. Crazy time that we're living in. And I think it's happiness because people are so sad and depressed, recession, everyone's broke. It's a fucking terrible time. This type of music lifts you up. I think the Big Frida shit, I appreciate her, so I appreciate that. I think it's phenomenal. Big Frida's always winning. Like, it's crazy. Big Frida's always winning. And Beyonce, this whole album. Now, with the whole album, what do you guys think? Comment down below. Will it be a house album like Drake did? I wouldn't mind it. I wouldn't mind it if it's done like this song. I think this song is impressive. I think it's a great song. Because I saw some commentary online, maybe on the opposite end. I like this song. Now, is it a classic Beyonce song? Time will tell. Because you're going to hear this in the fucking changing rooms, in the fucking elevator. You won't break my soul. You're going to hear that. So prepare your ears. But it made me want to let my hair loose like this. Like, I feel comfortable. You know, I went to Pride this weekend. You know, I'm married with a kid, basically. So I'm just saying, you got to release the anger, release the stress, be yourself, like how this song was kind of alluding to. I'm fucking with it. Now, obviously, oh, can guys enjoy this? Maybe not the typical guy. This is not that, though. This is not for you. If it's not for you, that's understandable. It might be for me, though. I'm not going to lie to you. You won't break my soul! Comment down below. How do you guys feel about it? Watch the uncut, raw, unedited reaction with the full song, not chopped up, in the Patreon. I appreciate you guys. Subscribe. Be safe. I'm fucking excited for this Beyonce album. I might call Jay-Z. I need someone in the car, representative of Beyonce. Shout out to Beyonce. She's watching. I doubt it. You know, she's the queen, the best performer of all time. So I think she has bigger fish to fry than me, but who knows? Time will tell. I appreciate you guys. I love you guys. I really do, even if I don't know you. And be safe out there.
They gonna love me for my ambition.